where the EU thus far have not been willing to confirm this thing about us being a third country, and therefore we could be in a position where food exports from GB to Northern Ireland would be illegal. Now, no Prime Minister, it seems to me, can contemplate that situation. But colleagues this afternoon will no doubt be thrashing it out. We've got a big debate in the House over the next few days, and we'll see where we land.
You know that Michel Barnier completely disputes the third country status, but my question is, could it break international law? If
it passes? Well, it could in theory, and there's precedent for that.
Are you comfortable with that?
There's precedent for that around the world. So, you know, I happen to be married to a Canadian. Canada breached international treaties when it legalised cannabis. There are often these situations that occur, but where countries face very, very difficult circumstances, and this is one of them. And I've yet to hear from people who would oppose this bill what their solution would be to this problem, where Tesco could not, in theory, stock the shelves in Northern Ireland. And that's a situation which we never expected to be presented with. Now, you say that Michel Barnier has denied that, but in fact, if you read his quite concerning tweets yesterday, they don't actually confirm that we'll be granted that status. And if they did, and Simon Coveney was pressed yesterday on this as well, if they did, then the problem goes away. But if it doesn't, we have to have this insurance policy, and that's what the government will seek to put in place over the next few days.
So in certain circumstances, you can condone breaking the law as policing minister?
Well, there are circumstances. I mean, this is the criminal law that I'm responsible for. No one's intimating that this is a criminal problem. It's